He was spat at more than once, although others clearly tried to remonstrate. By the time the small truck arrived with the young carabinieri riding shotgun, both men were grateful to ease themselves onto the tray and get out of there. The truck worked its noisy way parallel to the bay through narrow streets towards hillsides of olive groves. When they crossed the main road up from the wharves, Joe saw a huge poster that might have explained the reaction of the Italian women. There were smaller words that neither Joe nor Harry could understand. But across the middle was one word, defendila, which was easily translatable in concert with the cartoonish drawing underneath. A wild-eyed, dark-skinned man attempting to ravish a beautiful Italian girl who was trying desperately to push him away. As he thrust himself on the crying woman, the devil's hat was falling off the back of his head. "The hat's definitely a lemon squeezer," said Harry, adjusting his own. After inductions at the camp were completed, they were given a ground sheet and some bundles of straw and shunted out into an orchard riven by a dry canal bed. It seemed there was a choice of lying under the trees or in the canal. Thousands of men were spread across the land trying to find some shade. They were dirty, malnourished, and thirsty, while Joe and Harry were taking it all in, a noticeably pudgy individual appeared before them, waving a bag full of bread rolls. "You fellas will need a couple of these," he said in a broad Kiwi accent. "Will we?" asked Harry. "You'll find out soon enough. When you do, come to me at the cookhouse. I'll do you a deal." "What kind of a deal?" asked Harry. "I like the look of that wristwatch," said the man. "Do you?" asked Harry, slipping it from his wrist and holding it out to him. When the man reached for it, Harry swung his crutch into the back of his knees. By the time he hit the ground, Harry had handed Joe the crutch and his hands were at the man's throat.